بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم، الحمدللہ وکفا وسلام علی عباد الذین اصطفى، اما بعد، قال اللہ تبارک و تعالی فی الکلام المجید والفرقان الحمید، بعد اعوذ باللہ من الشیطان الرجیم، بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم، والعصر ان الانسان لفی خسر الا الذین آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر۔ فی مقام آخر قال اللہ تبارک و تعالی، تبارک الذی بیدہ الملک وهو علی کل شیء قدیر، الذی خلق الموت والحیاۃ لیبلوکم ایکم احسن عملا۔ فی مقام آخر قال اللہ تبارک و تعالی، من عمل صالحا من ذکر او انثی وهو مؤمن فلنحیینہ حیاۃ طیبہ۔ قال رسول اللہ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم، بلغوا عنی ولو آیا، صدق اللہ مولانا العظیم و صدق رسول النبی الکریم، و نحن علی ذلک من الشاہدین و الشاکرین، والحمد للہ رب العالمین۔ اللہم صلی علی سیدنا محمد و علی آل سیدنا محمد و بارک وسلم و صلی علیہ۔ رب اشرح لی صدری و یسر لی امری و اخلق عقدۃ من لسانی یفقہ قولی، رب زدنی علما۔ سبحانک لا علم لنا الا ما علمتنا انک انت العلیم الحکیم۔ مائی موسٹ ریسپیکٹڈ بردرس اینڈ سسٹر ناظرین، السلام علیکم ورحمۃ اللہ وبرکاتہ۔ لیٹس برنگ اور ہارٹس اینڈ اور مائنڈ ان اسٹیٹ آف شکر۔ وی ہیو نو ورڈس ہاؤ ٹو تھینک یو اللہ سبحانہ و تعالی۔ واٹ نمبر یو نو، سو مینی نمبر وی آر گریٹفل ٹو یو۔ You blessed us with Iman al-Islam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us with the last breath with Iman and Amal Saleh. Last khutbah, I covered what are the consequences of the sins, bad deeds. Today, I am covering what are the beautiful gift, beautiful benefits of Amal Saleh, good deeds. I quoted before you two ayat mubarak. One I quote Surah Wal Asr, in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives second condition of success with Iman. Everybody will be in destruction in the last, except those people who have Iman, illa allazina amanu, and wa amilus salihat, and good deed, and amal salih. Second ayat of Baraka Surah Tabarakallazi, in which Allah says, allazi khalaqal mauta wal hayata, لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا۔ We have given you life and death as a test. We were going to test you who does good deed. Brother, we did not come in this world by our own. He brought us for a while. We don't know. And He will take us away. The time period from the birth to the last breath, we are in the testing hall. Each and every amal, what we're doing, is being recorded. Two angels sitting over here, one writing good deed, other writing bad deed. Now, there's no U-turn. After death, where we are going, Inshallah, with the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we are Mu'min, we are Muslim. Inshallah, with the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we will go to Jannah's paradise. Inshallah, say Ameen. But here's a test. First thing, we should die with Iman. Iman is a passport of Jannah. But some Muslim, according to the Hadith Pak and Quran Sharif, the Ayat, some Mu'min even have to go to Jahannam for a while. May Allah save us, all of us. And to the non-believer, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them with the Iman. And they should enjoy your Jannah also. So, how early we can enter Jannah? If at the time of death, our record, our soul is cleaned from the sins, and only we have Amal Saleh, good deed. Now, this is a challenge. We have to lead our life with good deed, Amal Saleh. Therefore, every minute, every second, when we have to watch ourselves. What I'm doing, is it Amal Saleh or Amal Bad? It is acceptable or not acceptable? But this is the purpose of the life. Everything has been created for a purpose. This cup to drink the milk, this chair to sit down. The purpose of our life is وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لَيَعْبُدُونَ. For the marfas of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, purpose of life. We have to obey each and every commandment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the way of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is the purpose of life. What is Amal Saleh? Every action, what we do, if it is certified by commandment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and certified by Sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, permission, that is Amal Saleh. But third condition there also, it should be so only done to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Amal Saleh, Nek Amal, what is that? It should be Amar of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is based on Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sunnah and only to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subhanallah, we have to be watchful. Now, for that purpose, we have been given the time. Lifespan, each and every minute and second, we have to be watchful how I'm spending my time. We should be always involved in Amal Saleh. Now I go to the example. The highest level of Amal Saleh is when we do iqrar. When we say with the tongue, we believe, we say with the tongue, believe with the heart, shahada, la ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. Ashadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah. This shahada, this amal of the tongue is the best, highest level of nek amal. But this guarantee the Jannah, inshallah. Now we do amal. La ilaha illallah is yaqeen in the heart. And it should be shown by Muhammad Rasulullah by Amal Saleh. Now, second, Salat. Salat is, mashallah, is the best amal which has been ordained as the Arsh-e-Mualla. All other amal, ahkamat, came on the dunya, on the earth, but this salat was given to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the night of Miraj. So second best amal is a first make 5 times salat. If we make 5 times salat, we know that according to the Hadith Pak, we are taking a shower, a spiritual shower, 5 times. Our soul is cleaned. We wish we may take last breath, we are in the sajda. No matter what, salat ke barka in your life, your physical health, your spiritual health. Fasting is a good amal saleh. When do fasting, we should do fast in Ramadan. It will bless you with the taqwa. It will prepare us for the entire 11 month. How to use our eyes, how to use our ear, how to use our tongue, how to take care of stomach, how to use each every organ of the body. This benefit we Allah SWT bless us with the fasting. Hajj, subhanAllah, is a great amal saleh. If we go to Hajj, we come back like a newborn baby, fully washed from the sins. But we need more. Maybe I wish I'm doing tawaf, I take last breath. SubhanAllah, clean. And who are waiting for me? SubhanAllah, Jannah is waiting for us. Zakat, sadqat. Zakat, sadqat, subhanAllah, it cleans our wealth. If we do sadqa, it gives barakat to rizq. If we want to become rich, spend, do sadqa, give zakat of your property if it is required, your money, balance, ornament, we should give zakat. It will save our ornament, zevrat. It will give boost to the rizq. Apparently, we think that giving zakat, money go less. This is a dunya mathematics. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mathematics, money go ahead. We benefit more. So we should give sadqat. With giving sadqat more and more, we will have a very fine, nice death. Prophet said, if you are sick, do ilaj with sadqa. Therefore, I recommend it. Of course, we can get sick, human being. When we get sick, we go to the doctor. Before going to the doctor, we do some sadqa also. Sadqa is a spiritual medicine. And other is physical medicine. We have to take care of both things, spiritual and physical. So therefore, sadqa helps us solve our all worldly problems. So we should not neglect sadqa so many forms. Donation to the masjid, donation to the poor people. Zakat goes to poor people, not zakat goes to the masjid. No, not at all. Now, zikr Allah, istighfar is a beautiful amal. If you do istighfar, what Allah SWT does, cleans our sin. In the surah Nu, beautiful. Allah, the meaning of the ayat Mubarakah, very simple. If the people of the Qarya, the Quran says, if people of the Qarya should have done istighfar, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have given them male bani, male children, awlad, rizq, gardens, canals, subhanallah. And istighfar, you know that. It cleans our sin, and if we have problem, they are solved. Why we get the problem? We get the problem in the life, mostly, I will say, 99%. How many people can we are wali Allah? Only the problem came to the prophets for their test, to raise their status. For people like us, problems come to us because of our sins. Again, problems come to us because of our sins. Whenever we face any problem, right away, say, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un, and think what bad deed I did. In this era nowadays, tit for tat, you go right away, you get right away. For example, the person who does not serve his parents in the old age, he will have big problem. No barakah in his rizq. But on the other hand, if the person look at his father with smiling face, eight doors of Jannah are open for him. Looking at father, mother, with smiling face, eight doors of Jannah are open for him. To serve the children is an ibadat. When baby born, the woman get cleaned by the sins with this amal. Allah blessed with the baby. So mother is cleaned totally from every kind of sins. And mother becomes like a newborn baby. Subhanallah. Even Hajj, we do, there's no guarantee. If Hajj is accepted, then we become like a newborn baby. But if Hajj is not accepted, then maybe no. But in this case, mother become newly out of newly born baby, like a newly born baby, free from all kind of sins. Beautiful. Even when husband and wife love each other, then morning shower, all sins are forgiven. Washed out. Subhanallah. Ajeeb. Allah so merciful. It's because of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore, we should try to do all possible good deed. Looking at the ulama, look at the ulama with the love, with the alam, with the love and respect. Allah SWT becomes so happy. Allah SWT bless barakah in his rizq. And to whom you love, we will be raised with them. We should love Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Thus, we can love Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, more we obey his sunnah, more we bring his sunnah in our life, we will be more close to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Mere durood sharif, especially Friday, it is recommended, Friday, we should make maximum durood sharif. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad. If this amal of durood sharif, it will give us shifaat in day of Qiyama of Rasul Akram sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. More we obey Rasul, more we can love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Qul in kuntum tuhibbuna Allah fattabi'uni yuhibbukum Allah. O my prophet, tell them, proclaim, if you love me, if we love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they should obey you. by obeying the prophetic life, his life, his sunnah life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, God bless us with his own love. And that's the purpose of the life, to have love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, love of Rasulullah sallam, love of the parents, love of the children and the family. Another beautiful amal, a lot of amal, every good deed has benefit. Let me tell you. Ayat Pak says, Allah, bi zikrillah tatma'innul qulub. Without the zikr of Allah, you cannot get peace of mind. They are guaranteed. If we do zikr of Allah, we get peace of mind. Every good deed is also zikr Allah. You understand? Every good deed is also zikr Allah. Of course, we say third kalma, Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, La ilaha illallah, Allah Akbar. 100 times morning, 100 times evening, very beautiful amal. We got love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala ali Sayyidina Muhammad. Morning, evening, we say salawat ala Nabi, we will be close to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Our prescription, sometimes we are upset. Somebody bother us. I'm ready to fight with us. We get angry. What amal should we do? The best amal at that time, start saying, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ali Muhammad. Start making salawat on Rabbi. You will cool down. You will cool down. If I'm getting angry, tell, honey, say saldu ala Nabi. We get upset. This is a very good prescription. Say, saldu ala Nabi. Drink the water. Change the amal. Prophet said, when you are angry, if you are standing, sit down. Sit down, lie down. Or stand up. I recommend go outside fresh air maybe. Go to the living room. Or go to the bedroom. So change the condition and drink the cold water and salat saying, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad. Allah, you will cool down, you will be very good, peaceful mind. Lot of problem nowadays. I give you one amal, it will help you to save you, your family from 4 things. From jinnat, number 2, from jealousy, hasad, number 3, black magic, number 4, jinnat, jealousy, black magic, and one more thing, inshallah, I'll tell very soon. So from 4 things, jinnat se bachne ke liye, hasad se bachne ke liye, nazar-e-bad and jealousy, 4 things. Jinnat, nazar-e-bad, evil eye. Hasad, jealousy, from 4 items, 4 these things, if we want to save ourselves. Most of the time, our children, our family, we get sick because of nazar-e-bad. Very rare cases, jinnat come up. Nazar-e-bad. For that purpose, I advise you. For example, you might have noticed it. When we go with the family to any function, most of the time, women or children get sick on the way back. That's because of nazar-e-bad. People have some evil eye. For example, if I have jealousy against you in my heart, you bought the car, new car, and I don't like you. I'm jealous of you. My jealousy from the heart come through my eyes, and your car will get accident. That's jealousy. People get sick. And jadu. magic. It happened to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Nabeez bin Asim, Jewish, and his daughter, she did jadu. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam got sick because of magic. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Jibreel alayhi salam with the two last surah, surah Al-Falaq and surah An-Nas. You understand? These two surahs, these are tour of the jadu, magic. And Prophet got sick and Ibrahim started reading the ayat mubarak and Rasul Akram sallallahu alaihi wasallam jadu, it was done on the hair, blood hair of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Somebody stole it and then they put gaunt on those. So their last two surahs, it helped to remove the jadu, the magic. So to save ourselves, I'm talking, to save ourselves from the magic, any kind of magic, from jealousy, hasad, from evil eye, nazar bat, and jinnat, please read manzil morning and evening. MANZIL. You can go to internet and you can find, you can load on your cell telephone. You understand? Read morning before sleeping, Isha Salat, Fajr Salat. Read it. And after reading it, you blow on your hand and go over the whole body. Inshallah, you will be saved from four things. If it's my child, your wife, yourself, take the water, read this with a voice, whole manzil, and then blow in the water and give the child, or you are sick, drink the water. You understand, brother? And what is manzil? Manzil are the set of ayat of Quran. This is Quran Majid. Selected ayat of Quran Majid. Those ayat have, because Quran is also Shifa. Yes or no? So these ayat have special effect to take care of all these diseases. Allahu Akbar. Sickness come from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But he gave us also the solution medicine. Subhanallah. So this, please don't forget it. Even the woman can read the manzil in every situation, but with the niyat of dua. Understand? Otherwise, for recitation of Quran Majid, woman cannot read in every situation. With the niyat of dua, and every your adult child or child who knows how to recite Quran and Majid, please teach them this. You can print out, they can read it. But not, don't give telephone to the children. I told you already, until your child go to college, before college, don't give cell telephone to your daughter. You will lose your daughter. Tell you very frankly, you may lose your son. I get a lot of reports. Because social, bad part of social media, bad part of internet, is a very, very dangerous. One mother gave a gift of cell telephone when he graduated, became a hafiz. And after 1 year, she reported, my son forgetting Quran. Of course, if the hafiz of Quran has internet, not for homework is okay. how to control that. So be watchful. So this amal I told you already, please. That manzal brings a manzal in the life. Second, another thing. Please, every day, morning, read Surah Yasin. Surah Yasin is a mushkal kusha surah. Every day morning, this is a beautiful amal. Amal Saleh, read Surah Yasin the whole day. All your problems will be solved. All difficulties, obstacle will be removed. You understand, brother? You know, the highest obstacle and difficulty when we take gargara, last breath, at the time of death. So what we recommend? People should read Surah Yasin. When you see our loved one is close to die, the people read Surah Yasin, yes or no? It helps him. So if we read every day Surah Yasin, it will solve our spiritual and physical problem. Please, what message I'm giving to you, this message give to your family, to your friends, please. It's very important. Lot of other amal. Before driving the car, if you want to save yourself from accident, start the car, cold weather, let it run. Don't make dua when you're driving. Driving, subhanallah, sakhar, nahala. No, it won't work better way. No, I will recommend that. Let car run. You sit down. Subhanallah, sakhar, nahada, dua, you know that. Then read Ayatul Kursi with a voice. A family sitting, whole family should read like this. Ayatul Kursi. Then, وَمَا قَدَرُ اللَّهَ حَقَّ قَدْرِهِ وَالْأَرْضُ جَمِيعًا قَبْضَتُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ وَالسَّمَاوَاتُ مُطْوِيَّاتٌ بِيَمِينِهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى عَمَّا يُشْرِكُونَ. I hope so. This ayat mubarakah is Surah Zumar. Ayat number 77. You can check it. Surah Zumar, this ayat mubarakah. If you read this ayat mubarakah. And last three kul. Please, read this. Then blow on you, blow on the car, on the family, inshallah, and follow the state rules. Follow the state law. Speed is 60, you're going 80, you will get ticket. This dua will not help you. You understand? You're breaking the law of the state. To obey state law is amal saleh. Breaking the law is a guna, is a sin. So inshallah, you will save from accident. If anybody praise your child, praise you look nice, say mashallah. The word mashallah is the best solution from the nazar bad. Evil eye, the solution of evil eye is a mashallah. Even you look your own face, look nice jacket, mashallah. Sometimes aapko aapki nazar lag jayegi. Sometimes biwi ke nazar khamd ko lag jati hai. You look very dandy, nice, right? So she said, mashallah, you look very nice. Mashallah, honey, you look very nice. You understand, brother? Now I'm concluding. To have beautiful, successful life, peaceful life, please remain in zikrullah. Do good deed. Amal Saleh. Don't do any bad deed. If by chance happened, do tawbah istighfar right away. In our record, each and every minute, only there should be amal saleh, good deeds. Inshallah, then, with the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, jannah is guaranteed. So, akhir da'mana, and alhamdulillah, rabbil alameen, jazakallah khair, shukran kaseera, salamu alaikum, rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.